Welcome back, y'all. I've been gone for so long, don't kill me, but I'm back for good. Okay, so we're gonna go right into this fall vibes makeup look using the Too Faced Gingerbread palette. This palette smells amazing. It smells just like gingerbread. So the first shade we went into was Spices Nice. Then we went right on into Reindeer Paws because I love an orange in the crease whenever I'm working with a gold eye look because it just kind of makes the gold pop even more and just give it more dimension. So we're gonna cut that crease with the Too Faced Born This Way concealer in Chestnut. And then we're gonna put that warm and toasty gold shade all over the lid. Yo, this gold is to die for. Like, if y'all got this palette, when y'all open it, y'all gonna be like, what? Because that gold is so lit. And then I'm gonna use Reindeer Paws again to kind of close it up. We're focusing more on the gold. So this is just a way to clean up and close up that crease and just blend it in a little bit, you know? And then we're gonna go right into the Wet n Wild H2O liquid eyeliner. I love this eyeliner. I hate the brush. Not even gonna lie to y'all. I'm gonna keep it straight 100. I don't like that brush, but I like this eyeliner because it's like semi matte, so it doesn't stay shiny, which I think all of us ladies hate a shiny ass eyeliner. So I do like it for that reason. And then we're gonna move on to the face. So for the face, I'm using the Too Faced Born This Way foundation in Cocoa. It is a little darker, but come on, look at how chocolatey I look. Like I could just eat myself, okay? And then for my primer, I had used the Black Radiance Skin, the Refining Skin Primer. It says it's like a matte finish, but it gives off to me more so a smoothing finish. But either way, I really like the way it coats the skin and the foundation sticks right onto it. So you know I gotta use my good old beauty blender. I love a beauty blender. And then we're using that concealer, y'all. We're gonna hit all the hot spots. I have more of an oval face, so I like to really highlight those center points so you could just look straight at the focal point, okay? Which is that lit highlight and contour. And then the contour stick I'm using is the Fenty Beauty Match Stick in Espresso. This match stick is so milky and creamy. I really, really like it. Like, honestly, this is it for me. I don't even want to revisit no other match stick. Well, not really match sticks, no other contour shades. Like, this is it for me, okay? This is it. So I use my beauty blender for both. I use the pointy part for my highlight, and then I use the little booty part for my contour because I like my stuff to be married, okay? A happy marriage. We're not trying to get separated. Okay, that's why I use one tool and my beauty blender is wet. It's not just a little spritz spray, it's wet, damped, y'all. I wash my beauty blender before I do any makeup applications because I just love the way it melts the products onto my face, as y'all clearly can see. Okay, and this brush is the Wet n Wild brush. These brushes were a dollar, okay, and I just like it because it fits right in to contour this nose. So now we're using the Black Opal Invisible Oil Blocking Primer, or sorry, not primer, setting powder. And this was like a love hate for me. I didn't like it at first because it was really showing up real white when I took photos. But I revisited this product and honestly, I'm hooked now. Like, what? Wait till I pat this off, okay? Wait till I pat this off my face. And I'm gonna use a little bit of the setting powder underneath my contour because I kind of went a little too hard in the paint and made my contour a little all over the place. So I'm just doing this technique to kind of clean it up and make sure it's really, really crisp. Now, if y'all have trouble with the flashback or how harsh it looks under the contour, I do not set for long. I legit just put it on both sides and then wipe it right off. This is the Morphe Y3 brush. This brush is very fluffy. I love it to take off my setting powder. Hold on, let's just take a moment. Because one, I live by the train and the train is passing. And look at this beat, y'all. Look at this beat. Look at that finish. So now I'm using the Black Radiance True Complexion Contour Palette in medium to dark to set my contour. You have to set your contour because it can get really oily like concealer and move all over the place, and we don't want that. So I just set my face with the Mario Badescu spray. I love this spray. It makes my skin feel so tight. Like, I just really like it. And then we went right on to that highlight. You see that highlight, though? Hold on. Let me turn to the side for y'all. In this next clip. In another clip. You see that highlight, though? Okay. So this is the Babe in Paradise highlighting palette. This is the Morphe times Bretman Rock. And I use Shady Bitch, which is my favorite, okay? So now we're moving on to the lips. This is MAC. This is a MAC lipstick. This is in Funnel. And this is a satin finish. And honestly, I put the same shade but a liquid lipstick on top because this one wasn't giving me that much of that deep burgundy. So, yes, I went in with two different products on the lips. But it's the same color, just a better finish. Like, boom, there you have it. Thank y'all for watching, and make sure y'all subscribe, and please comment below and let me know what y'all want to see or what y'all think. See y'all later.